Patriots contenders and the Cardinals.
Yeah, fun weekend. Back here with Chris Caney, we are going viral. Check out the LSU Tigers' new football locker room, which comes complete with sleep pods. I guess you could say the players were pretty excited for the renovations. Go Tigers.
Honey Badger Tyron Matthew had part to do with this.
Yep.
Donated a big chunk of money to go along with a scholarship fund there. That is, looks like a spaceship, man.
That just shows you where recruiting is in college football now. Yeah. I mean, you've got to design these fancy facilities just to get the guys to consider coming to your school.
Yeah, all the top schools have unbelievable facilities. Typically, especially from a football standpoint, you leave college, you're at Ohio State, LSU, Alabama, you go to the NFL. Unless you go to the Vikings, Dallas, or some other teams, you go backwards. It's like the facilities are better in college than most of the pro teams.
Some of them players go backwards with the pay cap, too.
Oh.
I'm just saying. We don't have to go yet.
Hey, man, relax.
Just got to put that out there, CC. Yeah.
Virginia's basketball team, they paying them, not the football team.
No, clearly.
Yeah.
Why would they?
Wow, shots fired.
I mean, why would they?
They say nothing about that.
They pay the basketball players and the academic students. Football players,
not so much.
Let's talk some Dallas Cowboys, Chris Caney. Dallas got some great news yesterday. All-Pro center Travis Frederick is expected to be back in 2019. Frederick missed all of last year dealing with an immune system disorder. Caney, a lot of moving parts on this Cowboys team now with players who need to and want to get signed. But what is the ceiling for the Cowboys if they are all at full strength, everyone shows up and are all raring to go?
I think the Cowboys are one of the handful of teams that can be a Super Bowl contender this year. I mean, and I've said it before and I'll say it again, a lot of teams go into the season with championship aspirations. There's really only about 8 teams that have a realistic shot at winning that thing. And the Dallas Cowboys are one of them because they have an elite defense and they have a dominant running game. Now, if you add Travis Frederick back into the fold at the center position, I mean, you're talking about having one of the best offensive lines, if not the best offensive line in football. I think he's the best player at the center position that we have in our game if he's healthy. CC, I heard you talk about some of the things that he can do, getting out in front in the screen game, being able to climb to the second and third level to allow Ezekiel Elliott to spring some of those huge, big runs in the ground game. So if Travis Frederick is back, it's going to make that run game that much more dominant. It's also going to make Dak Prescott that much better of a quarterback. I think we've seen what Dak Prescott is without Zeke, and you've seen what this Cowboys team is without Zeke. With him, they're 28-12. Without him, they're a 500 ball club. So they need to have Zeke in the fold. They've got to get that contract straightened out. But this offensive line, if they're intact, that running game is going to be dominant, and that's good news because it complements what their defense does.
Yeah, their defense last season, when they won time of possession or the defense didn't play 30 minutes, they were undefeated, 8-0. So that should be the model. When they set up for every game plan, regardless, I don't care if Green Bay's playing a 34, I don't care if they're playing against the Giants, they're playing a 43, ours should be, we're going to run the ball 30, 35 times, win time of possession, and now you have one of the best offensive linemen, also one of the most versatile. And a lot of times it's not sexy. People don't want to talk about offensive linemen, but there's a few stars around the NFL, and Travis Frederick 2 years ago, that's what he was. You mentioned the best at his position. You mentioned his overall athleticism. So not only is he's not undersized, because typically the guards in the center are a little undersized compared to the tackle. So what does the defense do? They put their beefiest guys right on their nose so you can bull rush them. No move, just force them into the backfield. Travis Frederick is not having any of that. You can't bull rush him. He's also has the agility that he can get out on the perimeter, which opens up the screen game for them. So it's going to help Dak Prescott, because this year he's not going to have to worry about coverages, because when you have a veteran center, he's able to call out the front, call out the mic. When you hear it in the game, it's like Mike left. That means they're calling out the strength of the defense, means the offensive line is going to block to the right. So your quarterback, still being young and still growing, he's going to have more confidence. And as I talked to Sanjay Lau, the wide receiver coach in Dallas, he's expecting Amari Cooper, Randall Cobb, for them to really get better in their passing game. And one emphasis this offseason has been throwing the ball deep, making Dak throw it deeper. They believe Amari should be a better deep receiver, And Randall Cobb presents more speed than they had in the slot in a number of years, Nick.
When we talk about a great offensive line, very often we correlate it to success in the running game. Zeke has shown in his career, his short career, but these 3 years, he's going to be successful almost no matter which offensive linemen are out there. His yards per carry last year with no Travis Frederick all year, not too different from the year before. That he is a special enough player that as long as he doesn't have an awful offensive line, which he's never had, he's going to have success. The player who missed Travis Frederick the most was Dak Prescott. Mm. Since Travis Frederick's been in the league, the Cowboys had never had a sack percentage higher than 6. Last year, it was nearly 10. Nearly 10% of Dak's dropbacks, he was sacked. We talked about he and Deshaun Watson all year long being some of the most sacked quarterbacks. Deshaun with a piecemeal offensive line in Houston. Mm. Dak seemingly with a good offensive line, but without his center. And I had not even considered part of Dak's struggles, forget the sacks, but pre-snap, the added responsibilities.
Yep.
Since the first moment he came in the league, he had arguably the best center in football helping him out before the balls even snapped. With coverages, with calls, not coverages, pardon me, but with line calls and things like that, adjustments, mm-hmm. to have to adjust from that to a backup, maybe that in addition to Amari Cooper's coming there halfway through the year is what helped Dak get better throughout the season. So I think for Dak, an enormous year for him and for the Cowboys, an enormous year for them as a team, because they will not have paid everyone yet. And even if they do pay them, they won't have hit this year's cap. They'll be able to have all this talent. Having him back is critical. We talked to Mark Schlereth, who's the only player to have this syndrome and mm-hmm. come back from it. He said it might take a year, but he hopefully should be back. It's enormous news for Dallas. You're right, it's not a sexy position, but any team that's getting the best in the league at what they do back after missing them for a year, they're going to be that much better. It's the biggest offseason addition the Cowboys could make, bigger than Randall Cobb, bigger yep. than signing mm-hmm. Robert Quinn, mm-hmm. because he is an all-pro, top 50-style player in this league.
Yeah, exactly, and that's what it comes down to. And you look at where the Cowboys are at this year, they've been building to this point for the better part of this decade. Yes. When they rebooted this thing back in earlier this decade, I mean, this has been about a team that's offensive line was going to be one of its strengths. Now, they had the defensive side of the ball come along. They've made some smart draft picks with that. I mean, LVE, Jalen Smith, DeMarcus Lawrence, they've invested on that side of the ball too. But the identity of this team was going to be on the offensive side of the ball. And playing good offense starts with having a strong offensive line. It also starts with having to have a running game that complements your defense. So they have those things in place. This is the time for the Dallas Cowboys to compete for a championship, because as Nick pointed out, with some of the contracts that are coming due, they're not going to be able to keep this group together much longer. So they've got to take advantage of this window that they have this coming season.
Yeah, I think they're going to get the best offensive play that they've gotten in a couple years. I believe that Zeke, his understanding of what the lineman can do, it will make him a little more run savvy. But if you look at their offensive line, because last year we talked about the second round pick for Texas, Connor Williams.
Yeah.
Now he's a little undersized. So now, not only Zach Martin, the best right guard we got in the business, Zach Martin just got better because Travis Brack. So now I can help out Connor on my left, and not Tyron, the left tackle, he can block anyone by himself. So that offensive line, even though they might be the same, I believe they're going to get back to what we saw them 2 years ago, 2.5 years ago, where they were dominant and it was clear they were the best line in football.
And you've talked a lot about how Dak, while he's not Russell Wilson running the football, even though Jerry said he was Russell and someone else, I forgot who the other, was it Cam Newton, a combo of the two?
Mm-hmm.
The Cowboys, their ability to either do a little bit of the option game or certainly the screen game is so much better with Travis Frederick and Zach Martin there as your guard-center combo. The ability, like you said, to get out on the edge, to be agile. Some of the best highlights from the 2016 season were Tyron Smith and Travis Frederick just mowing down small people on little dump-off passes. They didn't have quite that ability last season, and for Dak to be able to run the football in the right spot, because where the Cowboys really struggled last year was that red zone and inside the 10-yard line. A more reliable center helps with that.
Last year, I put a mandate. I want Dak to be able to run the ball. He can already make 25 to 30 million.
Now I'm pulling it back.
Oh, no, no, I'm changing that, Nick. No, no, you can't be running so much.
Okay. Nah.
Because if you get injured with that money, no. So I got to pull that one
changing
back.
Changing it?
Yeah, year number four.
Chris Kenny, thanks so much for being here.
Appreciate you, man. Great
job. Take a break. Coming up, did Kawhi pick the wrong player to pair up with in L.A.? That's next on First Things First.
Stop playing.
And you've got a lawn care business in Jersey. Hit up Kenny.
Holla at me. Holla at me.